Isis.
I don't care how long I live in Paris. I'll never get over the view from high atop the Eiffel Tower.
It's magnificently clear tonight. You can see Notre Dame.
Oh, yeah.
And there's the Louvre.
Oh, look at that.
And oh, look! You can even see the cafe.
So you can.
Of course, it helps if you open your eyes.
Wife, gonna be the new advice columnist for the Weekly Globe.
You're gonna go work for that gossip rag?
That scandal sheet can't get anything right. They wrote I slept with de Gaulle once.
This was inaccurate.
Yeah, I must have slept with him 100 times. He may have been running the resistance, but he didn't get much from me.
And you are going to be advice columnist.
From now on, you guys gonna have to figure out your own screwed up lives. I'm a pro now. No more freebies. Ooh. All right, this is the last one. Hey, you, fashion criminal. Those pants go any further up your butt, they're gonna be a hat.
I'm a dead man. Just gonna lie down now and you can cover me with dirt.
What's the matter, Steve?
I can't hear you. I'm going toward the light.
Whatever it is, can't be that bad.
This hotshot corporate VP from the home office is coming to Paris tomorrow, and I gotta show him around.
So, what's the problem?
I don't know anything about this place. Oh, no, wait a minute. I do know one thing. I hate it here.
Yes, well, why don't you pass this on to somebody else in your office?
No, you don't understand. This is my one big chance to get out of here. These are headhunting trips. See, these guys fly in, they spend some time with you, they size you up, and then if it all goes well, they transfer you home. You gotta help me. I don't know what I'd do with this guy.
You know what I like to do? I like to try to find places that are a little off the beaten path.
No offense, Holly, but I need a native here.
Well, why don't you take him to the obvious places then? You know, the Eiffel Tower, Notre Dame, the Louvre.
The Louvre, that's a museum, right?
Come on, you've never been to the Louvre?
No.
What about Notre Dame?
Yeah, you know, you've seen one hunchback, you've seen them all.
Eiffel Tower?
I was on my way out the door to see it last year, but a Bewitched I'd never seen came on.
You mean you would rather watch a rerun of a crappy sitcom than go see a classic French landmark?
It was a Dr. Bombay episode.
Only Dr. Bombay.
Marcel, you gotta help me.
No problem. I'll write you up a tour with exact directions.
Oh, thanks, man.
You aren't going to hug me, are you?
No. Will you want me to?
No, of course not. Do you want me to want you to?
Dear Madame Ibarra, my husband never likes to go out. All he does is watch sports on TV. What should I do? Signed, frustrated in Philly.
Still frustrated. Your husband no good. Have him killed.
And this is my home away from home, the Café Américain.
Hey, bonjour.
Hey, Marcel. I want you to meet Roger Livingston. He's a senior vice president from our corporation back home. Roger, this is a very good friend of mine, Marcel. Marcel.
Marcel, Marcel. Whoa. I guess you had your share of ribbing around the old Ecole yard, huh? You're the first native I met. You are a native, aren't you?
Oui. Hey.
Yeah, well, here. Just one little. I have come here to immerse myself in your culture. Before I leave, I want to feel Paris in my gut.
Sounds very painful.
French humor, right? Right, that was some of that French humor. You're a funny guy. You know, we Americans, we're a pretty funny bunch too. Here's one of my favorites, and I know it's one of yours. Lady. Oh, lady. Lady. I must be doing this wrong. Wait, no, you know this. He got. Oh, there you go.
Anyway, I thought we'd get a bite to eat before we set out to do the town.
That's good.
Oh, Margaret. Roger, this is Margaret Hunt. Margaret owns the cafe. Margaret, this is our senior VP, Roger Livingston.
Hello.
Pleasure to meet you. So, is there anything I can get for you?
I want the Frenchiest cheese you have.
I'm sorry, the hearing. It sounded like you asked me for the Frenchiest cheese I have.
That's what I want, and a big honking slab of it.
He eats all that cheese. He's never gonna have a big hunk again.
And here we are back at the famous Café Américain, home of countless famous people who did all kinds of famous stuff. Well, Roger, what'd you think?
I thought it was weak.
I'm sorry, what?
Foul ball, bad toss. Steve, I came here to swallow Paris whole and spit out the bones. If I wanted to see the Arc de Triomphe, I would have bought a postcard.
Yeah, but I thought
it
you
was
said it
by the number, Steve. You've been here 9 years. I thought you could have done a little better than this. I gotta say, you let me down.
Well, listen, tonight I'm
going back to my hotel.
Ah, so how did the tour go?
Horribly. I blew it big time. I'm gonna get fired. I'm gonna wind up dancing for change in the park.
Oh, come on, it can't be that big a deal.
Oh, he thinks I have no spark, no imagination. He thinks I'm just another faceless corporate drone.
He got all that in one day. He is good.
I'm never gonna get out of here.
I'm sure they'll transfer you home at some point.
Yeah, right. They told me before I moved here that this was a temporary assignment. They said that coming to Paris was a way to get on the fast track. So I came. And a year went by, and another. And every year I kept asking them, when do I get to go home? And they kept telling me, just be patient. Well, I've been patient 9 years now. 9 years of watching other guys who I trained come and go home to jobs that I should have had.
What's that?
Each dot represents a guy who gets sent home before me. Bennett got sent to Duluth. Great ice fishing there. Nelson got sent to Green Bay, home of the mighty Packers. And Tremaine got it all. Topeka, Kansas. The big enchilada.
Well, I hope you're proud of yourself.
What?
You just sent him on a great big tour of the obvious. I mean, come on, Paris is more than Notre Dame. It's the flower seller behind Notre Dame. Or it's that vendor on the Rue Dauphine that sells those incredible Alsatian sandwiches. Or it's the old bookseller in the alleyway on the third floor that has that signed manuscript of Ulysses.
The one that flashed you?
Well, that's a part of the charm.
Why don't you take Steve and his boss on your tour of Paris, huh? With Steve!
What do you think? Is that worth a quarter?
Come here, let me talk to you a minute. I got an idea, okay. Why don't you take your boss to places that most Frenchmen don't even know about? Mm-hmm. You know, let him think that he's discovering a part of Paris that no American has ever seen.
Well, that sounds great, but how am I gonna find these places?
I'll go with you.
Really? This is great. This is great. I'm gonna go tell Roger. Oh, and Holly, I really appreciate this.
Hey, no biggie.
You know, I feel a little ashamed of the fact that you seem to know Paris better than I do.
Well, don't you get bored showing all those people the same things?
Actually, men and women receive slightly different tours.
Oh, come on, what are you telling me? You use tours of Paris to get women into bed?
Works like a farm.
That's charm.
Oh, really? Because I thought, you know, your American farms are models of efficiency, you know?
Well, I don't care what kind of tour you took me on. I never would have been so easy.
Oh, I don't know. First, we would have gone to the Louvre.
Hi, Jan.
Where we would have seen a single painting. Ingres, la grande odalisque. Oui? After being overwhelmed by its sensuous remoteness, we would move on to the Cimetière de Montmartre to say a prayer over the grave of Nijinsky and marvel at his brilliant madness. Our tour would end at Parc de Bagatelle, where we would contemplate the serene beauty of the water lilies while sharing a bottle of 61 Chateau Margaux.
Too bad. That would have worked.
So, how's the tour going?
Bonjour, Frère Marcel. Boy, Steve really showed us some amazing stuff, didn't he, Ollie?
Absolutely.
Oh, and he took us by this great theater on the Rue de something or other. What was that place, Steve?
Oh, right. That was Studio 28. The first structure built expressly for experimental theater in the world.
And a very special part of my Paris.
This is to you, Steve Sullivan. I underestimated you. Now, look, I'm going to check in at the office then, Holly. Steve, you know what we're gonna do next? We're gonna go up to the Eiffel Tower for a bird's eye view of Steve's Paris.
Listen, I think I finally turned the corner with this guy. I owe it all to you.
That's great. Listen, since you're home free now, you don't really need me for that Eiffel Tower thing, do you?
Steve, you know, I can't wait for you to point out all those famous landmarks to me up there.
You're gonna have to come with us. I don't know where the hell anything is.
Steve, I have a slight problem.
Little fear of heights, huh, Hall?
No, not a little. A big hunkin' fear of heights. Oh, God.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Would you look at that view? Paris looks like a glittering jewel box at night.
Boy, you really are afraid of heights.
Well, it's not the height so much as it is this overwhelming urge I get to fling myself off of them.
Hey, Steve, Mr. I know Paris like the back of my hand. Come over here and help me out. Now, where is the Cafe American? Right over there. Oh, and my hotel, where is it? Where is it? Is that it?
Absolutely.
Being up this high is the next best thing to jumping out of a plane.
Jump?
Boy, when the wind catches you just right, almost feels like you could fly, doesn't it?
Like I could fly. Oh, my God! Was that thunder? I think that's thunder.
Boy, there is nothing like a trip to clear your head. Steve, since I've been here, I've been doing quite a lot of thinking. Some of it involves you.
What?
Oh, yeah. That was definitely thunder. One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi.
You know, the fact you've been here so long made me think originally you were some kind of slacker. But now I'm beginning to realize...
One Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi.
It's just dawning on me. You love the bejesus out of this crazy old bird.
Steve, the storm, I think it's heading this way.
Did you see that? The lightning just blew the top right off that tree.
Oh, no!
Feel the rain! That's French rain!
Oh, yeah! It's great!
Steve! Now, I'm not gonna beat around the bush. I want to stay here in Paris. I want you to go back to Des Moines and help out my successor. Yeah! Now, think it over carefully. I mean, what kind of goober would want to leave Paris to go back to Des Moines?
Look no further! I am that goober!
Whoa! Steve Sullivan, you are one hell of a guy!
I'm going back home! The things that I've been waiting for 9 years!
I'm happy for you, Steve. Are those wonderful shoes?
Damn!
Okay. I love Paris! The wind, the rain! I feel like a god! I am master of my destiny! No longer will I be a slave to all of my petty little fears because I finally plugged into something bigger than me! I feel the power of nature coursing through my veins! Oh God, I've never felt more alive!
If it hadn't been for the lightning, all that cheese would have killed him.
That wake has stinky hors d'oeuvres. And as a vice columnist, I have to say, the blackened catfish was in dubious taste.
I can't believe he's gone.
Steve, just think, he's in a better place now.
Oh, who cares about him? I'd be in a better place.
Thank you.
Really tough about Roger, huh?
Yeah.
I just want you to know that nobody in the office blames you for killing him. Well, Betty does, but that's because she's carrying his unborn child. Just kidding. Anyway, I just wanted to tell you that the last report Roger sent to the home office was how incredible you were.
Really?
Yeah. He said that you were the backbone of the Paris office, that we'd be lost without you.
Just shoot me.
I'm really glad they got so much confidence in you, because that frees me up. I think I got a shot at Roger's job now that he's toast.
How you doing?
I'm okay, I guess. Listen, I want to thank you again for all your help. You know, this is actually the first time in 9 years I've had fun.
It was nothing.
Look, I suppose we could do some stuff together again sometime.
Well, sure we could.
You know, like you know, maybe go out to dinner. I mean, I know you and Marcel are, well, I don't know exactly what you are. But...
Steve, are you asking me out on a date?
Well, that depends.
On what?
On whether you'd say yes.
Steve.
No. I know. You're a nice guy, but I just don't feel that way. I know.
No, I wasn't going to say nice. I was going to say great. But to be honest, I don't really think this is about me. I think this excitement that you're feeling is all about Paris. Yeah, it's the same feelings that I had when I got here. The same feelings that everyone would have if they would just give this place a chance.
I don't know. I'm pretty sure I hate it here.
Do me a favor. When you leave here tonight, instead of turning left and going home like you always do, turn right. See where it takes you.
Okay. I'll give it a try.
How's Steve doing?
I think he's doing good. I think that he's come to a realization tonight, a realization that Paris is a magical place full of unexpected pleasures.
Everyone, come quick. Steve has been hit by a nun on a scooter.
Aim for my head!